Hello, I'm Anna Sekaran, Executive Vice President at Edelman, where I look after technology clients and provide strategic communications counsel on a range of topics. Before joining Edelman, I spent time at IBM, where I was the program lead for AI, academic initiatives, and public affairs. During my time at IBM, I helped the company nurture its global AI academic ecosystem, communicate its AI research agenda, and advance its positions and policies around AI ethics. I spend a lot of my time focused on understanding how new technologies impact people, business, and society, and that's what I'll share with you today and then cover more in depth during the summit panel. If you're not familiar with Edelman, we are the world's largest global communications firm with over 6,000 people in more than 60 offices around the world. Our core focus is helping businesses and organizations evolve, promote, and protect their brands and reputations. As part of our work, we have studied various dimensions of trust for over 20 years. We believe trust is the ultimate currency in relationship that institutions build with their stakeholders. Trust defines an organization's license to operate, lead, and succeed in every industry. To give you an idea of scale, this year we surveyed more than 34,000 respondents in 28 markets to understand what drives trust and how it's continuously evolving. That's where I'd like to start today with a look at a few dimensions of trust in technology. This won't come to a surprise to most. Trust in the technology sector continues to decline. In May 2020, technology had fallen from the first most trusted sector to the third, down a percentage point and now trailing food and beverage and healthcare. A lot of this stems from a worry that tech is out of control. According to the Trust Barometer, 61% of people say the pace of change in technology is too fast. And 61% of people say government does not understand emerging technologies enough to regulate them effectively. There are also serious concerns about automation. One in two people worry about job loss due to automation. This is a shared concern across 17 of the 28 markets we survey. The fact is, automation is not going away. Global spending on artificial intelligence is set to double in the next 4 years, growing from $50 billion in 2020 to more than $100 billion by 2024, according to IDC. So how do we prepare for future issues and dislocations stemming from the development and adoption of new technologies? The truth is, it's an extraordinary challenge. Right now, policymakers, corporations, academics, technologists, and everyday citizens are engaging in important conversations related to AI ethics. For me personally, I'm a tech optimist, meaning I don't think robots are going to steal our jobs or take over the world. Instead, I believe humanity will be stronger, safer, more sustainable, and productive with machines. However, this productivity and strength can only be achieved through responsible automation, which encourages establishing new best practices, principles, and regulations to guide and support human-technology interaction and collaboration. It's easiest to break down the concept of responsible automation into a taxonomy of four initial areas. This list will grow as the research expands and the applications continue to scale up and out. First, we need to understand how AI and automation will impact jobs and the economy, along with how best to advance shared economic prosperity for all. Second, we need to understand how we can ensure trust is codified within the technology itself. The third area we need to focus on is the importance of creating diverse and inclusive teams that develop technologies like AI. And the final area of focus is around how corporations, governments, and institutions need to be proactive in defining best practices around technology governance. In closing, technology is obviously a huge topic to cover, and there are so many ways we could look at the emerging issues. But I hope this has shed light on responsible automation and some of the key ingredients and emerging trends to watch. With a focus on what this means for accountancy education and the profession at large, I challenge you to consider the following. Machines will not replace accountants, but accountants will need to work more seamlessly with machines. Accountants in the mid to late stage of their professional career have already experienced transformation via Excel, 20 years ago, everyone was convinced this technological innovation was going to make the accountancy profession obsolete, which we know is not the case. With AI, accountants will have more time to focus on outliers and potential risks for their organizations. If you look at the way machine learning models work, things that are in the center are things that are pretty normal. They don't get flagged as the outliers. The more experience you have in identifying and explaining outlier situations, the more expert you will become in your field. So the humans actually become more of the expert, with the machine helping to optimize or augment the professional. Finally, learning and development is no longer something transactional in the early years of your life. In the future, learning will occur across your entire lifetime in a sort of agile learning model where we're advancing with the pace of change. The days of a moment in time where you learn everything are gone. In the future, my children will have multiple occupations, potentially in multiple different industries. I look forward to covering these topics and more with you during the summit. See you soon, and thank you for having me.